Let's try exponential scheduling, maybe. That's one of the ones that, as I mentioned, is kind of recommended as the first ones to use. We also have one cycle scheduling, and in this notebook that you download, I'm going to in the notes include also the code for one cycle scheduling, but that one is a little bit more complicated. So at first I want to start with something simpler like exponential scheduling, but if you want to try one cycle scheduling, you have the code and you can give it a try. So let me create the function that does the exponential scheduling. Quick reminder, what exponential scheduling or exponential decay does is basically given a number of epochs, here we're doing 10, every 10 epochs we are going to lower the learning rate by a factor of 10. So if we start from 0.01, after the first 10 epochs it's going to lower to 0.001 and so on. So that's kind of the working logic of exponential decay. And here is how we create a learning rate scheduler, as I also mentioned in the exercise for the specific lesson or module. So we are using the Keras callbacks learning rate scheduler function to make this function a way to schedule our learning rate. And then the last thing that I'm going to do is to include this inside my fit function as a callback. And that's all. But because we already run our network by for 60 epochs to see the results of how it performed, I'm also going to run this for 60 epochs and see if that's going to create a increase in performance for my model. So I will reset the model, start running it all the way from here. And everything is done. The scheduling is included. All right, we can start running it for 60 epochs. Now let's take a look at the results of adding this learning rate scheduling. I'll just scroll all the way to the bottom. All right, it looks like the accuracy, we weren't able to really capture it, the ones that we had with only regularization, and also the validation accuracy stayed quite low. But let's look at the progress. Okay, so it looks like in the beginning we were able to capture some progress. We increased the accuracy, we lowered the loss, but after the 10th, maybe like the 15th epoch, it kind of stayed the same. And if you remember, we lowered the learning rate every 10 epochs, so it looks like maybe it got a little bit too low. So yeah, maybe we can try changing the S value, so for per how many or after how many epochs we lower the learning rate. Maybe we can make it from 10 to 20 and maybe that will help. Yeah, but it looks like when we change it every 10 epochs, it went a little bit too low, so the learning rate didn't really help us make progress towards our goal or towards the minima. And yeah, so the value is not really good. But you know, we tried something. We tried exponential scheduling, and that's how it goes sometimes. You kind of do trial and error. As I mentioned, everything I tried in this exercise I've written down in this sheet. At first, we tried a batch size of 32. Well, we always tried a batch size of 32. We tried the regularization without the regularization, and then with the regularization, where the dropout rate was 0.1. We tried static and default learning rate, and then we tried exponential decay. We increased the number of epochs, and this is the accuracy values that we were able to capture. And the first one, we had overfitting. So even though it looks like the values are quite high, the more you train this network, the more the training accuracy is going to get higher, whereas the test accuracy is going to keep getting lower, and you're not going to have a really nice generalized network. So that's why it doesn't really work for us. And that's why we're trying to find a way to lower the overfitting by regularization while still keeping the performance high. We've kind of tried some random things here and there in the for this network, and I would like you to also try four different new approaches and note them down here. I would definitely want you to try power scheduling. I've shown you how to implement power scheduling in the exercise section, or how to implement section in the module, that in the relevant module. So I would like you to try power scheduling once with all the, maybe you can use like the same amount of values that we use in this last one, or maybe the previous one. So they're basically the same because we only changed learning rate approach here. So yeah, try the initialization version A. Again, I'll tell you what that is in a second. And the batch name, batch size 32, regularization dropout 0.1 for 60 epochs, and then see the results with power scheduling. And I would also like you to keep everything the same, but only use, maybe use the static learning rate, but only use the dropout rate, or increase the dropout rate to 0.2 and see the results. And the last two, you can try anything you want. You can maybe increase the number of epochs. If your computer is quite fast, you can maybe increase it to 100 and see the results. You can try a different learning rate scheduling, different static learning rate, different regularization technique, or increase or decrease the batch size and see kind of how it affects. But try to change only one thing at a time to be able to really understand the effect of what you're changing. All right, so that's your assignment. I'll also specifically note it down in the next section also. But so now for the initialization techniques.